In August 1914, I was torn between an intense curiosity to see war at close quarters, an intense objection to killing people, ideas of public duty, and doubt as to whether I could endure danger. In September 1916, I was attached to a motor ambulance convoy lent to the French Army. We carried the wounded and sick of the 16th Division of Infantry. Each country believes that its own armaments are purely defensive and that those of all other nations are probably aggressive. It is as if every soldier had courage printed across his back and cruelty across his chest. But the less a type of behavior is subject to free choice, the less also is it subject to moral condemnation. As the ends of wars have the same distribution, the background appears to be composed of a restless desire for change. It is futile to expect the status quo to endure, for history is but the record of its changes. I have a prejudice that the moral evil in war outweighs the moral good, although the latter is conspicuous.